A very good afternoon, everyone. My name is Shrutika Kripal.
And I am Pratishtha Bhardwaj.
And we are from River Yamuna. Yamuna.
Yes, yes, we are the sponsors of the Ayya Swami competition.
I have a question. I have a question for you guys. How many aircraft brands do you know which was not exist today?
Got it right.
And only one. Okay, there are two. There are two. Jet and Kingfisher. So yes. And today's topic is downfall of Kingfisher,
Kingfisher Airlines. Can we have the video? They already got it.
Welcome aboard Kingfisher Airlines. From the day we've started flying, I've tried to create the finest experience for you and bring back the element of style in travel. This Airbus aircraft is equipped with several unique features, which I hope you will enjoy. Food has always been my passion and drinks my business. I invite you to savor our fine range of cocktails and choice of gourmet cuisine that I encourage the finest chefs to create. Each member of your cabin crew has been handpicked by me, and I have instructed them to treat you as a guest in my own home. I know that you have a choice of other airlines. Thank you for choosing Kingfisher.
Ma'am, you hear the hooting when Vijay Mallya came? That's why we took this topic. This is the most controversial topic trending today, so that's why we took this topic.
Index history. Why Kingfisher Airlines faced a downfall? Reasons: financial crisis, Indian economy damage, SWOT analysis, comparison with competitors, solutions and conclusion. History. Do you know who was the owner of Kingfisher Airlines?
Yeah, I know.
Pratishtha, but I don't have chocolates.
And then I don't know.
Okay. Kingfisher Airlines is a private airlines based in India, Bengaluru. It was the second largest airlines in India, owned by Vijay Mallya. The tagline of Kingfisher Airlines is "Fly the good times." The airline was established in 2003, but it first operates in 2005 with four brand new buses. It starts its international operations on September 2008 by connecting Bengaluru with London. The first flight was Bengaluru to London. In 2007, 17.5 million passengers was traveled by 41 aircrafts. In 2008, the first, as I said earlier, the first international flight flew from Bengaluru to London. In 2009, within 4 to 5 years, the net loss was 418.77 crores. In 2010, the first CEO came. They started the company in 2003, but their first CEO was in 2010, who was Sanjay Agrawal. In 2011, more than 50%, they faced more than 50% loss. By the end of the year, in 2012, their license got suspended, and in 2013, they stopped their all the operations. Okay, how many of you travel by flights?
Almost everyone travels.
Almost everyone.
Oh.
So, what is the first thing you need to search or you like while doing tickets? Cheap tickets and cheap tickets, yes, time and sorry, Hospitality, yes, correct. Kingfisher Airlines was everything. They have good air hostess, good air hostess, good food, interior was good. But still, why Kingfisher Airlines faced a downfall?
So basically, there are four main reasons for the downfall. First is, it was a mismanagement which turned into a scam. It was not a scam on its first sight. It was a just mismanagement. Like, if I open a company, I would definitely hire a CEO. But this thought didn't came in Vijay Mallya's head. Maybe strategy or what, I don't know. So there was no management. Second point is expansion and acquiring. When its company is already going in loss, he acquired Air Deccan, which was already in loss. So that fall for all loss. And also, this wasn't enough. He had an idea of expanding the airlines into international, where there is high competition, huge investment, and very low margin. Third point is lack of operational efficiency. Vijay Mallya companies took those airlines which no other airlines took, and those were non-profitable. Fourth point is external factors. On this side, rupees was going down, dollar was going up, and on the other side, crude oil was going up. So these factors didn't work out for Kingfisher Airlines. Now let's have the financial crisis. So as you can all see, from where the company started in 2005 and till 2012, its loss is increasing continuously, and so are their secured loans. Indian economy damage. Salaries of the employees were delayed. They went on strike. And they end up with a loan of 9 crores from 17 banks. Kingfisher position was slipped down from 2 because of the crisis.
India's market share in March 2012. As you can see, within a few years, their market share has down. Their market share is only 3%. SWOT analysis: strength, weakness, opportunity, and threat. They got opportunity in international market, but because of mismanagement, they can't survive in markets. Strength, they have very good brand image. Weaknesses, high price for service offered, high attrition at the top brass, and the threat was the other competitors, and the fuel price was
were going up. Now let's have the comparison with other airlines. As you can all see, Kingfisher had high operating cost, and in spite all other airlines had comparatively low operating cost. And as I told, they took the unprofitable routes, and all other airlines focused their airlines on the only profitable routes. And they have very diversified air class. Like, first they went for economic to premium to mixed, and then mixed again to premium. So there was no basic, no static business model which they can handle. Solutions. So from my point of view, these are solutions which if Vijay Mallya had, so he could have not gone into that much of loss. See, there are only two ways of making money. First is, either they increase their sales, or second, they control their expenditure. So Vijay Mallya didn't focus on any of them. Conclusion: future planning is must. If we this is for everyone, not for only Vijay Mallya. If we start a company, we should have a future planning that how we are going to manage, what threats are we going to face. But Vijay Mallya didn't. So this is a golden statement of marketing. Expansion without gross margin is committing suicide. You are not having profit and you are just expanding your business. No, that is not gonna work out. Thank you.
Thank you.